Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Simplified, and today we'll see a new problem. So basically our problem is that we are given a stream of characters. Now we need to print the first non-repeating characters whenever a new character added into a stream, right? So for example, I'm basically explaining this stream as this character array. So it means the first character of the stream is this A, then I'm adding this A, then I'm adding this B, then I'm adding this C, then D, then B and A. So whenever we are adding any characters, at the same moment I need to tell that what is the first non-repeating character in this given string, right? Now if you see this case, here we have this A. So it means when I'm talking about this one, it means I have just inserted this A. So let me write it here so that you can get it better. So first I am adding this A. So when I'm adding this A, it means what is the non-repeating character, first non-repeating character? So because I have only this character, it means this is a non-repeating character, right? Then I am adding this another A. So when I'm adding this A, it means now this A is not non-repeating. Now it is repeated, right? So in this case, because there is no such non-repeating, so I will say it minus one. Then I'm adding this B. So when I'm adding this B, now this B is non-repeating character, right? Because this is the first time. So I will say the B is a non-repeating character. Then I'm adding this C, right? So even for C also, we have, even this C is non-repeating. For C, we have only one entry. But the point is we need to write the first non-repeating character. So the first non-repeating character is still B. So I will write B here. Now the next we are adding C, right? Now C is not repeating. But the point is that what is the first non-repeating? So first non-repeating is still B. So I'll add B here. Now add the D. So when I'm adding D here, D is also non-repeating because the entry of D is 1. But we need to write the first non-repeating. So first non-repeating is this B. So I will still write this B. Now we are adding B. So when I added this B, now B is no more non-repeating. Now B is repeated, right? Now B is also repeated. Now because C is also repeated, so there is only D which is not repeated. So now I need to print this D, right? And then I'm printing this A. So because A is already printed, so it means this D is the non-repeating character. So now I will print D, right? So this is what we need to do, that whenever we are adding any character, I need to print the first non-repeating characters in the stream. So first of all, we'll see the logic that how we'll solve this question. Then we'll see the time complexity and space complexity to solve this question. And then we'll see that how we can use it using Java code. Right now, if you observe from this question, that we need to basically maintain the two things. First of all, it should be the non-repeating. So non-repeating means the frequency of this character should be 1, right? It means I should have some way so that I basically know that what are the frequency of each character, right? So this is the one thing that I need to do. So if I need to maintain the frequency of the characters, then can I use a map? Right, so map is basically the best for this case. So in map, my key will be the character. So I can have the key as a character and my frequency we can take as an integer. So whenever I'm adding any, whenever I'm inserting any character, then I can know that what is the frequency for this particular character. Right? Now if you see here, the another thing that I need to maintain, that when I inserted this C, like let's say till here. So till here we have only AABC. So here we have two non-repeating character B and C, but I need to write only the first non-repeating. So first non-repeating character is B, right? It means there should be a way so that I know that which are the first non-repeating character. So for that, basically I'll take a Q. So Q basically store the number of non-repeating characters, right? So this is another thing that I need to know. Now it is not that it will only store only non-repeating, but using this one, we can basically take the help of to find out the first non-repeating character. So we'll see it later that how we are helping this or how we are taking the help of the queue. So this will again of the taking character. Now let's start one by one and then we'll see that how we are operating this one. So whenever I am adding any first element, so let's say I added the first element here A, right? So whenever I am adding this element, I am basically inserting this in map, right? So I am saying for A, whatever the frequency earlier, just increase the plus 1. Because earlier there was no earlier there was no frequency of A, this is the first time. So I'll basically add the frequency 1 with the A, right? Now what I will do, I'll check at the same time, after inserting from map, I will check that if the frequency of this character is 1, it means this is a newly inserted one. So I will add this character into Q also, right? So it means here I am taking this Q. So here I will add the element into Q, right? Now what I will do, now I will check the peak element of the Q. The peak element of the Q, let's check the frequency. If the frequency is 1, it means this is the first non-repeating character, right? So I'll print this character as my answer for this particular value. Now I inserted the second element as A. So again, I will update the value into map. So because this A was already in the map, so I'll update the frequency to 2. Now because the frequency of A is not 1, it is 2. It means this is not newly value. So I will not update this value into Q, right? So basically, if you observe, I am doing three things here important. First thing, I am adding in the map. Second thing I am doing, that if it is a newly inserted, how I will find out that if the frequency is 1, then only it is newly inserted. If the frequency is more than 1, it means this is not newly inserted. So if this is newly inserted, then I will add into Q, otherwise I will not add into Q. Right, so this is the second thing that I am doing. So right now I will not add into Q. Now the third thing that I am doing, that I need to print the first non-repeating character. So that I can identify using the Q. So again I will check that what is the peak element. Peak element is A. And what is the frequency? Frequency is 2. So if the frequency is 2, it means this is not non-repeating character. Now it is repeated character. So it means for the first thing I will do is to remove this character. Right? Now when I remove this character, now my Q is empty. It means there is no such non-repeating character. So in this case, I will write minus 1. Right? So I hope you have got the point. This is the first thing I am doing, add into map. Second thing I am doing, add into Q node. And third thing I am doing, I will basically take the peak element of the Q, and I will check that if it is 1, if the frequency of this is 1, then print the value. Otherwise check the first non-repeating character in the Q. So like here, because after removing this one, my Q is empty. So if Q is empty, then I will write minus 1, because there is no such non-repeating character, right? Now we'll add the new point. The new is B. So I'm inserting this B. So when you add the B in map, we don't have any entry of B. So it means I will add that this is the first frequency of the B. So this is first item. It means I will add into Q also, right? Now the first and second thing I am doing, now I will do the third thing. I will check the peak of the Q. So the peak of the Q is B. And what is the frequency of B? Frequency of B is 1. It means this will be the first non-repeating character till now. Right? Now I am adding this C. So when I am adding this C, it means C is also having the 1 entry. So if C is 1, it means I will add into Q. Now I will do the third thing, the peak of the Q. So the peak of the Q is B. And the frequency of B is still 1. It means this will be the first non-repeating character, right? So this is a benefit of Q, because Q will give me the first non-repeating character if the frequency of that element is 1, right? Now check this C. So when you are adding this C, it means I will update the frequency of C to 2, right? Now I will check again. I will check this thing, the peak of the Q. Peak of the Q is B, and the frequency of B is still 1. It means again, my first non-repeating character is B. Now I am adding D. So when I am adding D, now D, the value of D is not in the map. So it means I will insert the value into map. So this is the first time inserted. So I will add into Q also. Now again, the peak of the Q is B, and the frequency of B is again 1. So it means again, my first non-repeating character will be B. Now I am adding this B. So when you are adding this B, now the frequency of B has become 2. Right? So now I will check what is the peak of the Q. Peak of the Q is B. And the frequency of B is more than 1. It means I will remove this character from here, because now this is not more non-repeating character. This is now repeated. Now because this is in while loop, so again I will check the next element. So the next element is C. And the frequency of C is again more than 1. So again I will remove the character from this Q. Right? Now the next element is D. And the frequency of D is 1. It means now D is first non-repeating character, and you can see from here itself, the D is the only character here which is non-repeated till now. Now I will add this A. So when you add this A, I will update the frequency of A in the map. Now it is 3. And I will check that what is the peak of the Q. Peak of the Q is D and the frequency of D is again 1. So I will edit the D here. Now let's say you again insert the D also. Let's say I'm inserting D. So when you're inserting D, then you're updating the frequency of D. So now I will again check what is the peak of Q. Peak of the Q is D and the frequency of D is 2. It means I will remove the element. Now I don't have any element. So if I don't have any element, then it will be minus 1, right? So because if I insert D here, there is no such element which is non-repeated, right? So this is how basically I'll solve my question using these three ways. So I'll take map, then I'll take Q, and then I will, and then whenever I'm inserting any element, I will basically keep on doing this operation. So this is why if I have an element in the stream, my time complexity will be big of n. And the space complexity, because I'm taking map and Q, so it can at maximum store the n element, so it will be big of n, right? So let me show you the code so that you can get it better. So whatever logic we have explained, we have understood, the same thing we'll explain using code. So here I have this stream characters, and here I am the calling function print first non-repeating characters in stream, where I'm passing this character array. Now you are taking a hash map and you are taking a queue. Now I am doing this until from first element to last element, right? So now first of all I am adding the element into map. So here I am adding that map.put stream I. So basically this is character value, this is key, and the value I am adding is that there is a function in map that get or default value. So what it does, it says that if this value is not present in character, so by default value will be 0. So you basically add plus 1. Or if this value already present in map, so whatever value you have means you get that value and then you add plus 1. Right? Now this is a value, this is a thing that you are adding into map. And now this is a thing that you are adding into queue. So you are saying that if the value of this character is 1, it means this is a first inserted value. So if it is the case, then you basically add that value into queue. Otherwise you don't add value. And now you are doing this the thing that now this is a third thing, right? So first thing was in map, second thing was in queue, and third thing that I need to print the element. So basically this is how I check. So this is in while loop. This is basically to remove the element if it is more than 1. If the frequency of the queue's element, the peak element, is more than 1, so I remove the element, otherwise I break from this. So basically first of all I check the what is the peak element of the queue. Now I check if the frequency of the peak element is 1, it means this will be my non-repeated, so I break from this while loop, right? I break from this while loop. Otherwise what I do, I keep on removing the element from the queue if the frequency is more than 1. Right, and I do this until Q is not empty. Now there can be possibility that my Q is empty. If my Q is empty, it means I will print minus 1, right? Because now my Q is empty. If my Q is not empty, then I will print the peak element. Okay, so this is how basically I'll keep on printing the values from 0 to last element, right? So that's it guys about this video. And if you have any doubts, then please write in the comment section and I will try to explain that. And I will also put the source code into description section. So if you want, then you can also get it from there. So that's it. And if you have liked the video, then please like it and subscribe the channel for more such video. Thank you.